So, you are a great maker with that cool idea for an IoT device that you want absolutely develop using your developer board. Needless to say that it must be possible to control this IoT device from remote, maybe using a nice mobile app on the smartphone. But then you realize there's a mountain of stuff to develop. The firmware with the actual device logic, a way to provision somehow the Wi-Fi credentials, something running in the cloud, acting as a broker, which a device and the app use to connect to. And obviously, the mobile app, Android for you, and maybe iPhone for your spouse. Wouldn't it be cool if there were a way to concentrate just on the part that reads the actual sensor or maybe commands and actuator and get all the rest from the shelf? Basically, you focus only on your idea. Espressif, the manufacturer behind the popular ESP8266 and ESP32 chip, can help us here. Today, we want to show you how you can use Espressif's new Rainmaker framework to control your ESP32-S2 devices remotely from a mobile app. The big advantage of Rainmaker is that you don't have to care about the mobile app and the backend, so that you focus completely on your device code. By using the Espressif Rainmaker, you have also the opportunity to bind it with assistants like Alexa and control or query it with your voice. For this example, we are going to use our Maia dev board. To know more about the Maia board, check out the link in the description. Now, imagine you have your ESP32-S2 board controlling your Christmas tree lights, which you want to control remotely along with the temperature of the light controller. Let's see how we can easily use Rainmaker to achieve this goal. First of all, we have to set up some prerequisites. Rainmaker is currently based on the esp-idf framework. It's not clear if there will be an Arduino version. Here, we assume that you have the IDF already installed, since this is operating system specific. Make sure that you have the right version. It must be at least 4.2 or higher. Use this command to check the version you have currently installed. Okay, IDF is the right version. We are going now to clone the Rainmaker framework by using the git clone command and, of course, the repository URL. Once the IDF and the Rainmaker framework are both set, we are good to go with an example for the firmware. You can use an example in the Rainmaker framework, but in this guide, we are going to use our Maia board and an example we have in our Maia repository. As for Rainmaker, a simple git clone and the repository URL will do the job. Now that all the source code is in place, it's time to connect our ESP32-S2 board to the computer. Everything is ready and it's time to build, flash and test. We have to move to the right directory. So let's do this. And in our project, we also added a nice menu config. So if you call menu config, you find two entries which belong to the Rainmaker and an additional entry that we added. And that allows you to change the GPIO pins and also the period where the temperature is reported. Remember to save if you change something. For the Maia board, you can leave everything as it is. Important is to set the target to ESP32-S2. Wait for the configuration to complete and we are ready to build. Building is quite easy, just type idf.python build. Depending on your machine, this can take a while, so you have the chance to have a coffee. If you get an error while building, there's a good chance you have a mismatch between the IDF version and the Rainmaker version. If building was successful, then we are ready to flash. You can either flash using the new DFU protocol on the native USB port or using the legacy way, which is using the UART bridge. In this example, we are going to use the legacy way, so we have to let the IDF framework know what is our serial port. So let's trigger the flash command. We also add immediately the monitor command so that we get suddenly the logs from the serial port once the flash is complete. The flash process takes usually a few seconds, and once done, the Rainmaker framework is going to initialize everything, and at the end you should get this nice QR code. On the Macintosh, the QR code is not rendered in the right way. I had to change the interline settings in my terminal, so check the settings of your terminal to get it rendered in the right way. If you are still not able to get a well-rendered QR code, you can use the URL which is highlighted here and paste it into a browser. You probably notice in the logs that our code is already sampling the core temperature to report it. Now, to provide the credentials of our wireless network and to connect the device with the Espressif Rainmaker framework, we need the app. The app is available on Google Play Store or on the App Store if you have an iOS device. Search for Rainmaker, install it, and you are good to go. Once you open the application, you have to sign up. In this case, I'm using directly my Google credentials, which is a very quick way. Once you're in the app, you can start to add the device. Give camera permission so that you can read the QR code, and you have to give also a location permission because the app needs to access the Wi-Fi subsystem. And now the app is checking for the available networks. You enter the password of the Wi-Fi network, and once this is done, the application will pass this password along with the SSID of the network to the device. You see in the logs, the device is now using these Wi-Fi credentials to connect to the network and to start the claiming process. This means that it is using its secret key in order to establish an encrypted connection using the MQTT protocol with the Espressif servers in the cloud. In the last step, the app is checking if the device is now connected to the cloud. If this is successful, it will load whatever has been defined. In our case, we have now the temperature sensor along with the RGB LEDs, which we can toggle. In this case, we use the RGB LEDs as the Christmas tree example, but you can add a lot of more sensors and actuators. In the template that we used and that you can download from GitHub, we defined this temperature sensor along with the three RGB LEDs actuators. The code which are basically commanding them are all in app_driver.c. You see, this is the point where you can define all the sensors and actuators you desire or you have in mind. Another important feature you get with Rainmaker is the possibility to update your firmware via OTA, which is demonstrated in our template.